Hi everyone, my name is Esther. Thank you for watching. This is the last part of the series of about seeds. I did a series before about why you need to read the Word of God and how the Word of God can totally change your life. And as always, I will put my Bible in front of the camera. This is the Bible. This is the Word of God. And with this, your whole life is going to change. A change is going to come if you read this. So, as I said before, this is the last part of a four-part series about seeds. And we've discussed the parable Jesus is talking about in Luke about sowing a seed in different kinds of grounds. And the seed is parable for the Word of God, and the ground is your heart. So Jesus is discussing a lot of different kinds of hearts and how you can eventually get to good ground, so a good heart. And we've discussed all the good grounds, and today we will discuss the fourth and the last ground, and that's good ground, yay! So we all want this, we all need this, we all need to get to good ground. And in order for me to be sure that we are on the same page, I am going to read out loud scripture once again, and that's Luke 8, because this parable is written in Mark and in Matthew as well, but I will use Luke as a foundation, as foundation scripture. I will read out loud and the basic scripture. So anyway, I will read it out loud, and just to be sure we're on the same page. And maybe you think, once again, speaking out loud, reading in front of the camera, out loud of the Bible. Yes, I am, and the reason is why I really want to have the basis of the Bible, and really be sure that I don't mess up anything, or make something up, or leave something out. No, we need a foundational scripture, and that's why I read out loud. So, that's the explanation. I will read out loud. Lucas 8, verse 4. And when much people were gathered together and were come to him out of every city, he spake by a parable. He is, of course, Jesus Christ. A sower went out to sow his seed. And he sowed, some fell by the wayside, and it was trodden down, and the fowls of the air devoured. Ground 1. And some fell upon a rock, and as soon as it was sprung up, it withered away because it lacked moisture, the second ground. And some fell among the thorns, and the thorns sprang up with it and it choked it, the third ground. And other fell on good ground and sprang up and bare fruit a hundredfold, the four ground, a hundredfold, people, that's a lot. Okay, so anyway, in order for you to get to this good ground, you have to get rid of all these bad grounds. And you need to get rid of all the worry you have, or maybe you are offended because you experience tribulation, or experience persecution, or maybe you just don't understand scripture. I've discussed this all in the other parts. But anyway, I've got a lot of questions from people who ask me, how does it work? They say, well, I'm busy working on good ground, and I have good ground. What's next? How is it working? How is this seed is going to pop up? Well, for me to explain, as always, I will read out loud in scripture, and that's Mark 4, verse 26. But before I do this, I will explain this with my own experience and with my own life. As I said before, I've said it lot of times, I was in a lot of debt. Before I met Christ, I was in debt, and after I met Christ, I was in debt. And before I met Christ, my bank account was messed up, and after I met Christ, my bank account was still messed up. So what I did was I wanted to get out of that, but God's way, not my own way, or the world's way, or whoever's way. I wanted to get out of this debt God's way. So I searched scripture, I read it, I searched it, I listened to sermons, And I just didn't get it. I totally didn't understand it. And that's how I experienced that the devil stole it from me. So there wasn't any seed in me because I just didn't understand it. But I kept on going. I was persistent. I'm going to pursue this. I want this seed. So the Lord guided me to these scriptures. And then I thought, wow, I need to understand it. And I kept on searching. I kept on looking for understanding. And eventually, I understood it. I was so glad when I understood. Because I understood, I could give away. I started giving my tithe and offering. But then trouble came because I saw a little bit of seed popping up, and I saw a little bit of good news and good stuff. People would give me money, but then people gave me money, but then the mail came in and new bills came in. So that was tribulation for me. That was really, really tribulation. And then worrying starting. That were my distals, and I had a lot of distals. And I'm still working on to get rid of my distals. And so I needed to cast my care upon Him, and that's what I did. I made a choice. I made a choice to tell God all about my problems, all about the bills I couldn't pay. And then I would leave it with Him. So I made a choice in my mind. I made a choice to not think about it endlessly. I made a choice to think about the Word endlessly. And afterwards, it took me time. It took me a lot of time before I got eventually out of that. And within a year, or I think probably 2 years, I was rid of all the debt. And not only that, I don't have money problems anymore. Thank you, Jesus. And it's all because, not because I'm that great, no, it is because of the Word of God. So how does it work? We will discuss this. I will speak it, I will read it out loud in Mark 4, verse 26. That's my dog. He's walking across, and he's walking against the light. Okay. Anyway, I'll go further. And he said, "So the kingdom of God is the kingdom of God, as if a man should cast seed into the ground and should sleep and rise night and day." I'm sorry, I'm laughing at my dog. "And should sleep and rise night and day, and the seed should spring and grow up, and he know it not. For the earth bringeth forth fruit of herself, first the blade, then the ear, after that the full corn in the ear. But when the fruit is brought forth, immediately he put it in the sickle, because the harvest is come." So, I cannot tell you how it works. I can only tell you it works. And if you take care of the ground, God will take care of the seed, and he will let it grow. So please start working and take responsibility of your own ground and of your own heart, and get rid of all these stupid things, of all these bad grounds, and start reading the Word of God, and start speaking it and taking it, because this is the seed. Without the seed, no hundredfold. And it's not that I'm there yet, and I'm still not in 100-fold seed, but I am having results, and I am seeing fruit in my life as never before. And I'm so grateful, and I'm so thankful for this fruit. And this fruit I didn't even produce. I just received His seed and made sure that my ground, my heart is a good heart, and order for God to grow in my life, to grow His Word in my life. So that's it. And what I want to add, one more thing, is that it takes time. It takes time for for the Word of God to grow in you. So be patient, and because it's gonna come, a change is gonna come. But take the time for it, because you are worth it. That sounds like a commercial, but but it's true. You are worth it, and God loves you, and He wants you to have His Word. And so work on the ground, work on your heart, and receive it in Jesus' name. Okay, bless you. This is the end of my series, and see you in my next series. Okay, see you, bye.